Good afternoon, everyone. Today I'm here to give a demonstration on the implementation of pairing-based cryptography. Just now we have seen that Dr. Maithi sir has introduced us to the concepts of ID-based cryptography, and particularly ID-based cryptography and certificate-less cryptography. There are a lot of schemes that have used this pairing-based cryptography within their schemes. So let us start with the core preliminary of the pairing-based cryptography called the bilinear maps or the pairing function. The bilinear maps take two inputs, one element from the group G1 and another element from group G2, and maps to an element in group GT where the group G1, G2 and GT are of the same order R. So this bilinear map has three properties. The first is called bilinearity. Where given a p comma q from g1 and g2 respectively, and values a and b from a zq star, then the bilinearity property should satisfy the equation. The e is nothing but the pairing function which takes the inputs ap bp, where p and q are elements from groups g1 and g2 respectively. And when given such an input, it should output an element from the target group GT. So that would be E of P comma Q raised to the power AB. So this property is mainly utilized in various ID-based cryptography systems and also certificate-less cryptography system. Then we have non-degeneracy property. Where given the proper inputs to the bilinear map, the map should generate elements in the GT group. And finally, the third property is computability. There should exist a polynomial time algorithm to efficiently compute the pairing function. If group G1 and G2 are same, then the bilinear pairing is called symmetric bilinear map. So we see there is a practical implementation of bilinear maps. There are a PBC library, there is Miracle library. So we will be discussing about PBC library. Before that, I'll just introduce an example of a tripartite key agreement which was proposed by Jogues, which is based on this bilinear map. So based on existence of pairing function, there are a lot of schemes proposed in literature. We will look at the three-party key agreement protocol proposed by Jogues, where there are three entities A, B, C, and A selects a secret random value A, that is small a, if you could see. And computes public value AP and forwards AP to entities B and C. And B selects similarly a secret random value B and computes public value BP and forwards BP to entity A and C. And C selects a secret random value C, small c, and computes public value CP and forwards CP to entities A and B. Here, after each of the entities receives the values, they finally compute E of P, P, ABC, which is common with all the three parties. Note that steps 1, 2, 3 are done in one round and steps 4, 5, 6 are done in parallel. Finally, all have the same shared key, which is nothing but the E of P, P raised to the power ABC. This is a key agreement protocol between three parties. It is similar to Diffie-Hellman key exchange, which is for two party, but in when we come to the pairing based cryptography, we see that there exists a three party key agreement. The security of Jogues protocol, tripartite key agreement protocol, is based on the bilinear Diffie-Hellman assumption, where there exists no polynomial time algorithm to compute E of P, P all power ABC given P, AP, BP, CP, and this is said to be hard. I think you must all have got an idea of what is bilinear pairing and its properties. Now we will see the implementation of pairing-based cryptography. This is just the basics of the main concept, which is nothing but the bilinear map or the pairing function. Now we'll see the library that we'll be using. There are a couple of libraries that help to implement pairing-based systems. One such library is the PBC library by Benjamin Lin. So we will be doing a hands-on on this. I hope you are using. Right now, I'll be showing on a Ubuntu system how you can actually implement or implement this pairing-based cryptography library. The groups, the setup, like as sir told, in the ID-based systems, we have a setup algorithm, then the key generation algorithm. So all this can be implemented using this library. So I'll show you the details of a complete step-by-step procedure to download, install, and work out some examples using the PBC library. Before we need to install, before we install the PBC library, we need to install GMP library, M4, Bison, and Flex. Because PBC is built over GMP, and M4, Bison, and Flex is necessary. So like if anyone is also having an Ubuntu system, then they can simultaneously perform the steps that I'm going to do, so that you will finally install the PBC library and we can start doing the hands-on session. So if anyone is having an Ubuntu system, like we'll take 2 minutes, you can just open the terminal, then we'll start working out. Okay, like if whoever has this Ubuntu or any Linux operating system can open their terminal, and we will work out in setting up the PBC library. Okay, and others who do not have an Ubuntu system, the steps for Windows would be shared later because I have not yet worked on that Windows operating system running the PBC library. But you can note down the steps for the Ubuntu system so that you can easily work out in future. But others who are already having a Ubuntu system can simultaneously work with me. So first we need to install M4, Flex, and Bison. Then you can type the command sudo apt-get. I think it is visible on your screens, right? Sudo apt-get install M4. Then it will prompt for your password. You can give your password. So I have already installed M4. That is why it is not.
Manohar, are you typing something on the terminal?
Yes, sir. Is it not visible, sir?
No, it is not coming actually. Maybe you have shared the PPT or something. This terminal is showing, but at least to me, whatever you are typing is not being so.
Sure, like.
Now it is coming.
Maybe okay, it maybe it is a little bit slow. Okay. Yes, sir. So first we have installed M4. Similarly, we can install Flex and Bison as well. So previously I've installed this software, so that is why it is not what it is already saying that there is a newest version available. For others who have not installed, it will take a little bit time, but it will be quick. So then we'll install also Bison. So after we install all these three software, then now we will see how to download and set up the GMP library. Because GMP forms the core component of the PBC library, we will see how it can be downloaded and installed. Now we can go to the gmplib.org website, where you will be finding the downloadable file. sorry, gmplib.org. So once you see in the home page, in the left side, you can find there is a .tar.lz file. So you can just click on it. It will be downloading. So just choose a folder where you want to extract the downloaded GMP file. So basically, I'll be doing it in documents. So hands-on. So I have just now downloaded this. So once you download, you need to extract the file. So you will get a GMP folder after extraction. Now you have to cd into this using the terminal command, or you can directly click, right click and open in terminal. So that should actually cd into your specified folder, GMP 6.2.1. So now after the extraction, we need to configure the GMP. There are three steps basically for any library or a program. So first you do the configuration dot forward slash configure. So once you configure all the configuration helps in getting ready the build the software on the specific system. So it will take maybe like less than a minute to actually build it. So once that is done, we will run the make and make install. And if anyone is having a problem, let me know. Like whenever you are running these commands in your system as well, who are simultaneously doing, so that I can help you. So finally, you will have the GMP installed, the latest version 6.2.1. And wherever it is being stored, the libraries, it would be in user local lib. And for all this to work out, you need to have a GCC compiler. Most of these Ubuntu systems will have a GCC compiler. If not, you have to install the GCC first. Then you have to install the M4, Flex, and Bison libraries. So once the configuration is done, you can just run the make command. So the make will help to build the software and generate a final customized make file specific to the system. Once the make command has been run, then we will have a check whether the make command has been successfully run. That is using make check command. Depending on the system capabilities, the time to execution of these commands also depends. So mine is like 8 GB RAM, and it is taking a little bit more time. If someone has a good powerful system, then it will take less time then. And others can note down the steps, whatever we are doing. That will actually be helpful if you are even running in Windows. But there would be another prerequisites where you have to download a CYG Win or Ming GW software. So it will actually help you to work on this GNU GCC tools. Okay, so right now it has successfully run the make command. Then we'll just check with the make check whether it passes the tests or not. So there is make check command after make. So the make check command will test inbuilt functions or the programs that are already available, whether it has properly installed, like properly configured or not. Now finally, we'll install the GMP using the sudo make install command. You can see here the caution: if you have not already run make check, then we strongly recommend you to do so. So since we have already run make check and it was running perfectly fine, so our GMP has been installed correctly. So right now GMP has been installed. Similarly, now we will see how to download and set up the PBC library, the actual PBC library. And PBC is dependent on GMP. That is why we have first installed GMP. The PBC can be downloaded from crypto.stanford.edu site, or you can just type in Google. Crypto PBC or Crypto Stanford PBC. So this is a free library, C library, free to use. So you can just click on the link, first link, and you can also note down this web page, crypto.stanford.edu /PBC. So this will take you the homepage of the PBC library. This is actually maintained by Benjamin Lin. This work was his PhD thesis work, where he has implemented the first, one of the first practical pairing-based crypto system. So in the left side, if you could see, there is a download option. Click download. Then in the download, the first link, the tar.gz file, which is the source code, PBC library source code. Just click on that and download it. You can download to the same folder where you have downloaded the GMP file. So I'm just saving it. Now extract this downloaded folder to the same folder where you have installed GMP. And you can similarly open, right click, and open in terminal, or you can cd into the specified folder using the terminal. Anything can be done. And same like the GMP, you have to configure make check and install. So right now I'm running the configure command. If anyone is also working simultaneously and facing any problems, please let me know. So previously I have told you that we have to install Bison Flex. Since we have installed, there is no problem. If someone has not installed, then there would be an error for this Flex and Bison. Now run the make command. So after the make command, you can run make check, or directly you can install. There wouldn't be any problem because here there is no test cases. So now we'll install it with the sudo make install command. So it has been installed and it is quite fast. And if you can see here, libraries have been installed in userlib, user local lib. This has to be updated into the configuration file. So what we can do is that we can edit that configuration. You can create a file, new file into that configuration folder and update the library's location. So that will help while you run the programs, it will help to link those libraries. So now we can edit or create a new configuration file and update that specific location. So sudo gedit nano or vi, anything that is just an editor. So you can use anything, sudo gedit. You have to, the configuration file is available in the etc folder. So it is /etc ld.so.conf and .d / the file name, whatever file name you want to give. Right now I'm giving a new lib.conf, but you have to see that it has an extension .conf so that the system can understand it as a configuration file. So previously I've already updated this specific etc folder, and I've also created, that is why it already exists, but generally it would be a new file for other people who are doing for the first time. So you have to basically type this location or the details. So it would be user local and lib with all forward slashes. So just save it. And run the there is one command you have to run, ld config, so that all the changes are updated. Ld config command has to be run. Okay, it should have been run with a sudo because it needs administrative people or root access, because it is in permission. See, you can see that the permission has been denied. So you have to run with sudo command, super privileges. Lconfig. So it has been successfully updated. The links and the cache would be updated. Now we can try and test some code. First, we'll start with very basic. So we can run pbc /pbc. Which will take us to some interact. So this pairing based cryptography, where we have seen previously, there is a G1, G2, GT groups. The G1 group, and if G1 and G2 groups are same, then we have a symmetric bilinear map. So right now, whatever we are testing has G1 and G2 separate, which can actually be transformed from G1 to G2. So we'll see with small examples. The syntax would be, G is nothing but any variable. You can choose any variable. So for example, previously also when Sir was explaining, there is setup algorithm and there are some global public parameters. So those global public parameters can be defined. That we'll see in in the code, but here to test how the group elements are generated and what is the code to generate different group elements, that we will be working out now. So here G is nothing but a variable. Then you have a colon and an equal to sign, similar to normal programming, but there is little bit syntax difference. So then you have a RND random. RND here itself is a random value, G1. So G1 here defines the group G1 of the bilinear map where it takes inputs from G1 and G2. So this is the group G1. Then to print that element G1, you can just type G and a semicolon. So here you can see that the value G is randomly chosen, it is a elliptic curve point. So the PBC library is based on elliptic curves, and the elements G1 and G2 are from elliptic curve points itself. So previously, if you have seen, there are three properties. The first property, bilinearity, is an important property. We will just verify the bilinear property, whether it is really satisfying or not, using some small code. So right now we have generated an element G. Similarly, we'll generate an element H. So if you have previously seen, there are like the pairing function takes two inputs, one from G1 and one from G2. So one we have already generated, which is a small g, that is from G1 group. And next we are generating another element from G2 group, that is H. So both are elliptic curve points, and you can see that it is randomly assigning points from the group. Okay, so once we have got a G and H, then we'll define a pairing. Pairing is already built in function here. So G comma H, because we are giving input G1 and G2 elements, which are nothing but a small g and a small h. So that will output you the pairing value. Then we will check the bilinear property. So we'll also define, if you have previously seen in the slide that I have provided, there is a small a and small b that are from ZQ star. That values also can be defined using similar syntax. A is the variable where you will be storing those random values. So similarly, R and D you'll be using, but here you will change the group name. Previously it was G1, G2, here it would be ZQ or ZR, depending, like Q and R nothing but the order of the groups. So here it is predetermined as R, so we'll take it as R. Then you can also print that A value. So previously G1 and G2 are elliptic curve points, but A, B, whatever we are going to do would be in ZQ. Means it will not be a point, but it will be a value. So we can see that it is a value. Similarly, you can also do for B. And anyone who are simultaneously doing along with me, if you are facing any problem, let me know. Okay, so similarly we have got A and B in ZR, and now we'll check the bilinear property. We have to compute two values, the LHS and RHS. We'll verify whether LHS and RHS are the same. I'll just show you the slide again so that you can find what I'm actually trying. If you could see the slide, here we have generated all these values. PQ, instead of P and Q, we are assuming it as G and H. And A and B values have been generated. Then we'll compute the LHS and also separately compute the RHS and verify if both of them are the same or not. So we have got the LHS value. Similarly, we'll check the RHS value. Okay, I think I misdoed something. Okay, if you could see, LHS value has the same point output GT group. This element is in the GT group, and also the RHS has the same. So this actually shows that the bilinear property is satisfied. So this is a simple example. Then we will see how to write the code or what are the data types that have been used in PBC library. And I'm just minimizing the terminal. So if you have extracted and done all the steps, finally you'll have an example folder in the PBC folder. There is a example folder as well. So in the example folder, there are a lot of examples which are based on pairing-based cryptography. Like example, Bonelli-Sachin. This is a short signature scheme which is based on pairing-based cryptography. All these examples are available and they can be run. Before running, I'll just explain you the syntaxes of what means what. So here there is one more thing we have to edit in this .c files. The pbc.h, the location is a little bit different. We have to update it with pbc/ because these header files are available in that particular location. So once you have updated this, then we'll see that this pairing p will define the pairing function where elements belong. So basically, this element t will defines the elements, but it does not configure to any particular group. So we have a different function to configure this particular element to one particular group. So element t can be used. This is a data type to define any element of this pairing-based cryptography system. So if you can see, everything is element-y. You can just use a comma for all this. But these elements correspond to, like whenever you want to specify which group they belong to, then we have a different function called the element underscore init underscore whatever the group. If it is G1, then it would be G1. Then if it is G2, then G2, GT, ZR, anything. And also you have to specify the variable, whichever element you want to configure to this group, and the pairing. So you with this command, you specify that this small g corresponds to a group G2 for the pairing. We have written it pairing. It can be anything, like it is just a variable. So this is would be the initialization. Then in this there is no setup algorithm, but I'll show you another scheme where there is some.
Manohar, you may please wrap up in 1 minute.
Yes, sir. So I'll just show you how you can execute this. Just open in terminal. The command would be simple as you compile a GCC similar, but there would be one difference when you run it. So you can give some output, some text name, then the file, example bls.c, and you have to link the libraries. This is important. So you will use these commands to link the libraries, gmp and lpbc. Without this, it wouldn't compile and there would be warnings or errors. Okay, so I have not updated or saved it. As I told you, the file, I have not saved it, though I have updated. Okay, and right now it has saved. So once you run, it executes properly. Then the test, you have to give the parameters which are located in a different location. So this would be the final command that I would discuss with you. So just copy the location. It would be almost from here. Copy this. Paste it here, and there would be param folder and a dot param, and there are different type of parameters. So you can just turn a dot param. Okay, there is. Okay. Oh, I missed the forward slash here. Okay, so this is just the method to compile your programs, whatever C programs. The example problems would help you out to design schemes, and this is a signature scheme, and all the protocols discussed by sir previously can also be implemented as per the algorithms that are in the scheme. So that would be it, and this would be the completion of the implementation of PBC library. If anyone has any doubts or having problem with implementation, you can contact us later as well. And thank you.
Thank you very much.